There's different ways they come to the conclusion, but this is basically, it boils down to, there's something in your heart that says, I need to do this.
Yeah.
And it's, I think that's what most people, they say it a little differently, but that's what it boils down to. You know, there's something in your heart that says, you're supposed to do this. And if you're lucky enough, you make it happen, and it's a wonderful ride.
Both hearts. It's good for the heart, and it's good for the hard heart.
Yeah, the soul, the spirit.
That heart, yeah.
Yep. And I have, everybody's got long stories of how they get to that point.
But yeah, how'd you get to that point?
I had done section hikes, very small, three-day weekends, and with friends. So I had experienced a little bit of what the trail was. And I finished a section hike last year in Harper's Ferry, where the headquarters is. And just before I got into the headquarters, I met an older lady who was walking down the street, and she stopped us and asked all kinds of questions about where we're going and where we're coming from, and told us all these books about the AT that she's read and how much she loves the AT, and that she was physically unable to do the trail, but she was going, driving her car, she was from Ohio, driving her car to each state that the AT passes through and walking 1 mile. And she asked us where there's a flat spot that she can park her car and walk in Maryland. And that was all that she could do of the AT, was just, you know, a mile of flat in each state.
Yes.
And we talked for about 10 minutes, and you could just see how she just loved the AT. But more importantly, I saw in her eyes regret that she didn't do it when she could have, when she physically could have. And she never said, oh, I wish I'd have done it when I was younger, but you could see it in her face.
Yeah.
And 2 minutes later, I'm in the headquarters, and there's a picture of a guy at Katahdin. He's done the whole trail, and it's a sort of famous picture, and he's leaning on the sign, and he's either praying or crying or both, or but he's there, and the emotion from that picture is so strong that within 2 minutes, I saw somebody's face that had a regret that they didn't do it, and I saw a picture that was such strong emotion that of someone who did do it, that the contrast hit me like that. I was like, I need to do it so now, I don't have that regret.
Did this all happen in the same year?
It happened within 2 minutes. I met the lady,
man.
And then, how you doing? I met the woman, and then 2 minutes later, I was in the headquarters looking at that photograph, and I knew right then and there that I needed to do it, that I wasn't willing to live with that regret.
How long ago was it?
That was last April 9th of 2010.
Wow. And you did it.
And I just knew in my heart that I was supposed to do it. And I resigned from my job. And
oh, really?
Yeah. You know, it was that important. Like, there was nothing more important in my life at the time, and still to this day, there was nothing more important. I needed to do it, and I knew it. And so, and I have no regrets, and I'm supposed to be here. I'm right where I'm supposed to be. I've said that even when it's raining or snowing or getting eaten alive by mosquitoes, anything that you would think would be, you know, that can be considered a hardship, I'm still right where I'm supposed to be. That's part of the experience. And it's easier to see when you're on the trail and you have the time to be in your thoughts and the quiet, and it's easier to, there's less clutter going on in your mind with the outside world. You can get into that grind of, you know, it's a busy life. You know, when I'm not on the trail, I stay busy. That's why it's important for me on the outside world to take at least, I take like 20 minutes at the end of the day and just have quiet and to try to get a little bit of this where you can hear your heart, you can hear your spirit, you can hear your God talk to you and say, this is right, this is wrong, this is what you need to do.
It's interesting the way you put it, on the outside world.
Yeah. It's important. And even still, how that it's so important that I take that quiet time to listen. And it's really important. I know it is, but I get so busy in life that sometimes I even skip on that.
Where you can't always hear them in the outside world.
Yeah, exactly. your senses come alive out here. The first thing I noticed was that my sense of smell, I could smell things so much more clearly and strong. And I don't know if that's a, you know, because of just being in the fresh air or what caused that, you know, but I definitely realized that my sense of smell was enhanced. And I
think it's part of that is being in the present too.
All the senses, I think, are enhanced. That's why it's sometimes, I think, difficult for people when they first get out here to sleep the first few nights, is because you're hearing everything. You know, there's a lot of noises in the woods. It's quiet, but especially at night, there's a lot of things rustling around. The animals
the coyotes are part of that quiet.
Yeah.
And it's kind of a paradox that you have quiet, but the sounds of animals and rustling of leaves and everything, but that's quiet because it's not distracting. It engulfs you. I mean, I'll be dozing off some nights, and man, the coyotes will wail.
Yeah.
And I just listen to them.
Yeah.
Just listen.
Yeah. And the owls are and it is true. I mean, the woods are quiet, but it changes. Like, I notice that there are some times where the woods are just quiet. You don't hear nothing. You don't hear no birds, no animals, nothing. You hear the wind maybe in the trees.
I wonder why that is.
And sometimes. Then other times, yeah. It's amazing. The birds are just, it's noisy. There's so much activity. And, you know, I don't know if that's, you know, it's definitely not the way I'm hearing it. It's just the way it is. There's times where the woods is quiet, and there's times when it's noisy. What? All in, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, he's a good friend of mine that I met on the trail. And we've been hiking together. You know, I hike solo, but we tend to camp at the same areas. So probably since Pennsylvania.
And you're from where? Where do you call home?
I live in Delaware currently, in Newcastle, Delaware, but I'm from New Jersey originally.
Delaware Dave.
Yeah.
Now, how'd you get that name, being from Delaware?
It actually has been my nickname for about 6 years now. And I thought getting on a trail that I would get a trail name given to me. And without even telling anybody that my nickname was Delaware Dave, within 2 days, a girl named Wilsey, I told her I was Dave, that I was from Delaware, and that I didn't have a trail name yet. And she said, "Delaware Dave, that's got a nice ring to it."
She
had a big smile on her face. And then the next thing you know, in the journals at the shelters, they have the shelter journals, and she started writing Delaware Dave. You know, we write notes to each other, and it just stuck. And it was natural because it was my name before I got on the trail. But I think the best trail names are given to you versus the ones that you choose for yourself. There's less ego maybe in that.
Well, you might catch up to, or you may have already met him, Jelly Pants.
I met Jelly Pants and I started in February. So I do know Jelly Pants. And then we didn't see each other for about 3 or 4 months. And we just met again, reunited in a way, yesterday. And I hadn't seen him for months. So it was good to see somebody who you started with, who went through some of that cold and snow in the Smokies.
This probably isn't a... Yeah, because I just talked to him.
Yeah, him and his dad.
And his dad.
Uh-huh.
But I know this is probably not a good question. But what are your plans after this is over?
That's an excellent question, but it's not an easy question. I know that I'm going to have a difficult time adjusting back to the old life that I lived. This has been I slowly, gradually, in the last 5.5 months, have gotten to this point where I am right now here, and to go back into the everyday life and work within a few weeks is going to be a radical change. I'm not going to have that luxury of the gradual work my way back into society and the normal life.
Right.
So it's going to be difficult, I believe, but I'm probably going to go back to the same job. I did resign from it, but I left on good terms, and so I'll probably go back to the...
Oh, that's good.
...to work, because, you know, you're not making any money out here, which is... not the most important thing in the world, but unfortunately, I gotta make money so I can hike again.
There you go. What was that?
We were meant to meet up right here. I was reading a book, and one of the lines in it was actually No Country for Old Men, but the line just jumped out at me, and I wrote it down because it made a lot of sense. It did to me anyway. It was, especially when you meet somebody like this on the trail, for every common destination, there is a common path. Not always easy to see, but there. It makes sense, you know. With this trail, it's easy to see that path. You know, if somebody gets on in north and somebody gets on south, the path is right here. But in life in general, sometimes it's...
But that, that
if you meet somebody or something, you know, you're at that same destination. Even for us to meet on this trail, you had to go through what you went through in life. I had to go through what I went through in life to get right here. So there's a common path other than this trail.
But that's, I think I'm hung up on the semantics of what a common path was, because I'm thinking just the opposite, that was that we took two entirely different paths, brought us to the same place.
Exactly. But oh. Once we meet here, then those paths are connected. It's the same path.
Then it's common.
Yeah.
Well, it is common if you look at it as being connected from beginning to end.
Come on through, guys. Don't let us hold you up.
Start to the end.
Yeah. I don't know. When I read it, it was late at night, and how y'all doing? It was late at night, and it just jumped out at me as something that it sounded simple but profound, and I just...
You wrote it down. Yeah, I do that, too.
And when I meet people along the trail, I think of that there's this common path that we, you know, that led to this common destination. Sometimes you can't see it, but the path is there either way, regardless.
If you really take that as fate.
Yeah.
You know, it's... And you got to stop and acknowledge it. Well, yeah, there is such a thing as fate.
Yeah. Now I've got things to think about. It was a pleasure to meet you. I'm going to head up on the trail and go see Gene and Hugh.
Gotcha.
Take care.
Enjoy it.
Bless.
Say hello to Katahdin for me.
Will do.